A well-known tradition at the University of Santo Tomas in Manila makes its return for the first time since the COVID pandemic hit. College freshmen once again made their way through the historic Arch of the Centuries during the school's welcome walk on Tuesday. Rife with meaning, it also marks the start of a new academic year in the university. USD was forced to carry out this tradition virtually in the past due to the threat of COVID.
This is actually the life and culture of the University of Santo Tomas, that we celebrate the rite of passage, especially welcoming our freshman students.
Thousands of classrooms in the Philippines' Central Visayas region yet to be repaired ahead of the school reopening this month. The Education Department's regional office says that's around 5,000 classrooms in need of repairs, with others deemed in severe condition after Typhoon Odette's onslaught last year. The DepEd in Central Visayas is urging more stakeholders to join its Brigada Escuela to help repair school facilities in time for the official start of classes on August 22nd.
Advocacy group Move as One Coalition, dismayed by the veto of President Marcos Jr. on the proposed Philippine Transportation Safety Board, or PTSB. Group's co-convener, Robert C., argued the measure would have strengthened and made transportation services safer. He adds it would also streamline processes, particularly on road accidents. Aside from different government agencies handling these accidents, C. points out there is a limited capacity to conduct an investigation. He believes a dedicated agency would have solved these issues.
Sana po makonsider na ma-override ng Kongreso ang act na ito, ang bill na ito, or pwede sanang i-refile. When the veto was made, yung rason po nila ay duplicative or wasteful yung expense na ito. But let us consider po yung value of human life. Halimbawa po dun sa mga traffic collisions natin, opo, every year, opo, halos mga 10,000 to 12,000 fatalities ang na-experience natin.
Opo.
How much is life worth, diba?
The Public Works Department points to the ongoing repair of three drainage systems leading to the Dolomite Beach as the cause of flooding in parts of Manila. Secretary Manuel Bonoan says they expect to complete the renovations by September. He admits the project has been delayed due to lack of funding.
Ito naman po requirement kasi ng DENR na dapat natin proteksyonan yung Dolomite Beach para hindi madumihan. Pwede ba kung makumpuni ho namin lahat ito by middle of September or latest end of September po?
Meanwhile, the local government of Manila asserts it is coordinating with the public works and highways to address the flooding issue. As the Manila LGU awaits action on the matter, Mayor Honey Lacuna Pangan says they have devised plans to help ease the burden of flooding. These include offering transportation assistance to affected commuters. Lacuna Pangalan adds the LGU is continuously declogging waterways to prevent heavy flooding.